What is up, guys? This is Data Ripwin with a surprise guest host of this update league review video. My boy Friday Spinus is back in the league and he's back to help. Tell him what's up.
What is good, y'all? Y'all know who I am. Better know who I am.
Okay, guys, like I said in the last video, we were definitely exploring other options as far as doing the league rankings ladder system. I'd like to thank HC Gaming for everything that he's done for the week, and thank him for giving me the green light to go ahead and try and do something better. Not that his system was anything bad, but obviously there's certain things that aren't working right, and that's a lot of burden for one person, so that was another thing that needed to be looked at and simplified, man. Basically, this is about trying to make things easier on everybody. Easier on you guys, because you'll know exactly where you stand and why you stand there. Easier for myself, because with me doing the update videos and to take on the league ladder by myself would be insane, and this league probably be over in about a week, because you know that much pressure on any one person is enough to make them want to quit. So I understand him taking a break. So with that being said, we have a new way to send your fights. There will be no longer texting me. You go to this email address that is up on your screen right now, www.fntlresults@gmail.com. That will be the place to send all your pictures. Some of you guys that record videos, the stats, they need to be a lot more visible, or you're going to have to start sending pictures in. Like, I'd like everybody to send pictures into this website. Therefore, it's right there. And Fight Night Spinus has offered to take care of that as far as calculating everything. I don't have to talk to you to get your pictures. I don't even have to go to the email. He is going to have it all put together. We have a brand new point system that I'm going to get into here in just a second. But he's going to be the one basically putting it all together. All I have to do is simply look at the picture that he sends me, and then I have everything that I need to update the league ladder, and it should not take very long at all. So we are going to be looking to do that more. We're going to do it on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, but remember, this only works if you guys cooperate and send your pictures in. Please don't make me hound you for your pictures. That shit is annoying, and I don't like it, and then therefore I will not like you, and then that just doesn't seem to end up well for people, so just don't do it. Like Nike in reverse, you feel me? Alright. So a lot of things have changed, guys. Some of you guys aren't going to like it at first, but I beg you just to bear with me, or hit the door, man, either way, you know what I mean? This league is going to be awesome, and whether you choose to be a part of it is on you. So we're going to go ahead and get right into some of the changes that are going on. In OWC, they have a point system. From the get-go, I thought it would be cool and I thought it would be effective to do that. It seemed too complicated at the time because nobody knows exactly how they score it and what they score for. But talking with Fight Night Spinus, who talked with Arachnid Soul, who has a successful wrestling league, he had it. So he knows a lot about this. I certainly don't. HC knows more than me, but like I said, he's taking a break, so you know, it was nice to have that expertise. So Finance Spinus talked to him, Finance Spinus talked to me, and we sat down and looked at every single problem that we could think of, looked for ways to change it. Some of it, there's no way to really change it unless you start kicking people out, because it's on them and how they fight. But for everything else, I think we have found a solution to. So I'm going to go ahead and kick it over to Finest Finest, and he can explain the point system to you guys.
Okay, so like you said, we got a brand new point system. And this point system will allow you guys to be able to know where you stand in the rankings, and it will also allow you to challenge higher opposition. For starters, let's talk about the point values of each fighter, which will probably be the most important thing. So we came up with a new point system and algorithm that will allow everybody to understand where they stand. Bad news. We categorized everybody, includes myself all the way down to maybe the worst fighter in the league. So everybody now has a new point value attached towards them. The WBC champion of the world, Labriziana in this case, is worth 16 points if you are able to defeat him. The WBO champion in a Militiamatic is worth 14 points. The IBF champion is worth 12 points. And then that's when we come down to the majority of the league is the guys underneath that, because there can only be three champions. Now, for each fighter that comes in a different category, it's based on your skill level, your activity, and your consistency. So elite fighters are worth 10 points. Those are the fighters like the Dave the Rip ones, the Big Loxes, myself, you know, the Doc Doses, fighters of that magnitude. Fighters that are, you know, have shown that they can be consistent, they know the ins and outs of the games, and they are just dominant fighters, and basically everybody knows who they are. Now, under that, we have professional fighters. These guys are worth 7 points. Professional fighters are the guys who could be elite fighters, but they just need to make a couple of tweaks to their game and be more consistent, and then they'll be right there to fit into that elite category of being worth 10 points. So like we said, pro fighters or professional fighters are worth 7 points. Those are the Ennis Houstons that come in at moments, you know, they look like beasts, and then other times they, you know, revert back to things that don't always allow them to win matches. And then 5 points worth is the amateur guys, the guys who are just coming into the league, the guys who are just starting to get themselves established, you know, the guys just starting to get their feet into the pool, just testing the water, and guys, you know, who haven't always fought the best competition or, you know, been known as duckers. That's the reason why they're worth 5 points. And in terms of coming up, everybody can become an elite fighter. Everybody can't be a champion, but everybody can be an elite fighter. And the way that's determined is based on if you're winning consistently and how close your fights are and how many points you're scoring per fight. So if you're dominant one fight, and then when you go up high level competition and you're giving them trouble, that will allow us to advance you moving forward. I'll kick it back over to Dave now, and he will explain some more stuff.
Okay, guys, those are the point values for each fighter. Keep in mind that those are points that you earn only if you get the victory. As far as how your other points are scored, and the, you know, what you're being scored on as far as your in-ring game goes, we're going to go ahead and cover that now. For every round that you are able to win, whether you win or lose the fight overall, you will gain 1 point. In OWC, you lose points. I don't think that should be the case here. I think anybody who puts an honest effort in should be getting credit at least for what they were able to do well. So if you win a round, you get a point for that round. If you manage to score a knockdown in any round, you will gain an extra point for that. So say you win the round and then you score a knockdown in that round, that will be 2 points for you, and so on and so forth. If you score 5 knockdowns, you get 5 extra points, and that leads us to the next point, how you win. 3 points for a decision victory, you know, on top of your 1 point for a round and on top of any points that you may have gotten per knockdown. If you win by decision, it's an extra 3 points on top of all that, and an extra 5 points for victory via knockout. It's simple common sense on why that is. Obviously, it's better to knock your opponent out than to let them last the whole time. As far as people go with landing shots and good defense, we want to reward guys that are, you know, not just going out there and throwing wind bump punches and, you know, trying to get lucky shots. We want to help benefit and encourage guys to be accurate fighters. So if you finish the fight with an accuracy rating over 50% of your punches thrown, you will gain an extra point. And also, if you hold your opponent to only landing 39% of his shots, you will also receive an extra point on top of that. So these are the in-round game, in-round point system on how you're scored as far as during the fight. And then, like we said, you get the extra points for the class value of your opponent that you fought. So now that you guys understand that, we're going to go ahead and finally take a look at the actual league ladder, and then we will get into a couple other things. So you want to take it away, Fighting's Finest.
Yeah, sure. Okay, now we're looking at these ranking ladders, and you're like, what the hell? I was not there before. You know, I don't belong there. But let's take a quick look at the bottom. There's your boy 3 spots or 2 spots away from the bottom. So I'm all the way down there. And the reason why you don't hear me bitching and complaining is because everybody is at the same point. They're at the same point value. Nobody has any wins. That means the record has been wiped clean. Everybody has a chance. Champions stay where they have. And then we just put guys based on the consistency and, you know, how much they fought in the league, how many wins they had, you know, that kind of thing. And guys who weren't as active or people who have quit the league and then come back, they're more towards the bottom. So that's how the ranking ladder was set up. But like I said, it doesn't matter at this point because Reezy Too Cold, as you can see, was the last person right there, can be the first one to fight. He can get 10 points or, you know, 20 points, 30 points, how many points he is able to capture, and he can be number one versus his opponent. So basically, it's first come, first serve, and everybody has a fair chance to go ahead and, you know, be towards the top. So that's the way that the ranking ladder is looking, and you'll come up based on your points. Now, here's two more important things that we have to talk about. Challenging the champions. Like, what if you want to be the WBC champion? Well, you have to be ranked 1-3 if you want a chance to be, or a title shot at the WBC champion. If you want a chance at the WBO champion, you will have to be able to capture a ranking from 1-5, and therefore you can challenge for the WBO championship. And then for the IBF championship, the one that's still a championship title, and you know, it's definitely a great position that you want to be in. You capture extra points for fight. That one, you have to be ranked 6-10. We don't want the top five guys to be at the IBF belt. We want them, to be towards the IBF belt at 6-10, and the higher level guys at 1-5 get the WBO and WBC titles because, you know, they've earned it. So that's the way that championship rankings go, and it's still open challenge. You guys can challenge anybody from rank 1 to 27 or 28, whatever number is supposed to be at this time. And you know, go ahead and get your fights. Try to fight the best competition you can see out there. And whenever you win, I'll add your points there. And that will be determine how the ranking ladder goes. Back over to Dave.
Yeah, guys. And I just want to say that this is a rough draft of this picture, to say the least. You see them zeros looking like they on some crack or they're drunk right now. I can assure you that will be looking much more purdy as the days goes on. We basically did this, in the span of a night and a couple hours. In that time, we've come up with a completely new system. I understand there's going to be questions. There's going to be, you know, why am I ranked there? I don't like how my points values are scored. But as you can see, as we've told you, those things are easily changeable by your effort. And it's going to be the guys who are fighting the best competition are going to be the guys climbing up the ladder faster simply because they get more points. There might be, you know, some bias in the beginning because we had to start somewhere. But from here on out, how you perform is on you. Where you are on the rankings ladder, it's going to be on you. No more he put me there because he doesn't like me or anything else that you kind of try to throw at us. You know, it's going to be on you, and it's going to be transparent for everybody to see. You know, you'll know how many points you got to beat this guy, so you can fight accordingly. And, you know, I think if this system is given a chance, I really think, you know, that we can make a good run at this and make this something that's going to last as long as Fight Night Champion lasts. At any rate, I still think it is much better than OWC, and any action to try and correct problems, whether it's, you know, even if this doesn't pan out at first, we have to change some things. That's shit you gotta do. There's gonna be growing pains, there's gonna be problems, and as far as I'm concerned, as long as Fight Night Champion's around, I'm gonna be here to try and do those things for you guys. We all love this game, we all want to see it continue to be as long as possible, and I'm gonna do whatever it takes to make that happen. So thank you to Fight Night's Finest for coming on the video with me. Thank you for your help on coming up with this new system. Thank you to HZ for all the work that he has put into this league as well. And I think that's pretty much it, man. Do we forget anything?
No, I don't think we've forgotten anything. Just know, like you say, your performance and how often you're fighting, your consistency is going to determine where you are on this rankings leaderboard. And just understand this, guys. Like, if you're ducking and you're not willing to fight, you're going to be the guy that's all the way at the bottom. And when people look at the leaderboards, they're gonna know why you're there at the bottom. If you're spamming and you're running, you know, you're going to get your ass the hell out of here. Nobody wants to deal with that, and nobody wants to have to put up with that. So we're hoping that you're responsible enough to go out there and fight that the way you're supposed to fight. go out there and try to get as many fights as you possibly can get in, you know. And guys, I noticed a lot of you are scared to do league fights. Don't be scared to do league fights. Win or lose, you're going to gain some points, and win or lose, you're going to get better. So the records don't even matter right now. It's your point total that's going to end up getting you to where it is that you need to get. So fight as many guys as you can. Not saying there's anything wrong with sparring, but you know, don't be afraid to step up for bigger stuff as well.
This is all about you now, man. You know, you got to show that you want it. If you want to be champion, you got to, you know, put the effort in to be champion. If you don't like seeing the same guys fight for title shots, you don't like seeing Dana Rook win the title picture, fighting Ace Spinas in the title picture, then come take us out. Show us what you're working with. Show us that you can be elite, and you will go far in the league. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys are as excited as I am to see how this works out. And most importantly, I hope you guys give it a chance. Because like I said, you know, you might not look where you're at right now, but it's easily changeable. That's the main thing. And I think most people are excited to see a fresh start. I know I am. So that's pretty much it, guys. Good fights, good nights. Thank you to Finest Finest again. And we are out. Peace.